fortunes of the Karnataka Congress last time in the assembly elections in 2023. Mr. D.K. Shivakumar, the Deputy Chief Minister of Karnataka and the President of the KPCC, joins us today, just days ahead of, the elections here in Karnataka, especially the southern states. So, just a couple of days to go for polling. How confident are you at this point in time of a good Congress performance? Because, you know, the hopes are really high at this point in time on you, the top brass, after what you managed to do during the assembly elections.
See, I have full with vigor and confidence more than the assembly election, because the biggest strength of what we have today is that what I had promised in the time of assembly election, the people believed us, people gave us a massive mandate, and no prime minister, no double engine government worked, but ultimately they gave a solution to us that we are able to fulfill the promises what we have delivered. And the people across the state, cutting across the party line, even people voted for BJP, voted for Janata Dal and voted for other parties, they feel that we have been benefited out of this government. We should be loyal to them. We should help them. And the biggest issue today going on is the price rise, unemployment, and the farmer related issues. So ultimately we all are very happy that the people are responding very well, and we'll have a big mandate has been done in the assembly polls. That is why the JDS and the BJP both joined together, and they wanted to defeat us. It is impossible to defeat us.
How do you make, what do you make of this alliance really? Because do you feel that the Vokaliga votes really will shift towards, the NDA because of Mr. Devegowda, Mr. H.T. Kumaraswamy, or do you think it makes no impact?
It is a failed chapter. It is a failed chapter. Since the party was almost in the verge of collapse, so they are trying to join hands with them. Mr. Devegowda's 50 years of public life utterance on the secular image and secular name has been vanished. They have sold their property to the BJP unofficially. That is what it looks like. That means not in the field of their hypothecated itself.
So you also did make an interesting statement just a few days ago about Vokaligas and how they should think before casting their vote this time, about how you belonging to the community have been given responsibility of being the Deputy Chief Minister. But you said that formerly a Vokaliga was made to step down and you blame the BJP for it.
No, of course, Mr. Kumaraswamy, we all supported him. We wanted to be a Chief Minister for 5 years. We wanted a secular government in Karnataka. We supported him. Now Kumaraswamy has joined with the people who only backstabbed him, who removed him from the chief minister. It is no ethical and moral values which has been attached to it. In public life, one has to have some morality. I think they are completely failed, and the people of Karnataka, in future, they will never believe them.
Okay. So, Mr. D.K. Suresh seems to be a big target at this point in time. He was a sole Congress MP last time. You have Mr. Amit Shah, who started his campaign in the Bengaluru rural segment. Mr. H.T. Devegowda is putting full focus there. Mr. Manjunath being selected as the candidate. How are you viewing all of this? Do you think it's a stiff fight?
No, of course, all elections will have a fight. But the same situation has occurred when Suresh was first contesting. Both the Janata Dal and BJP had contested at that point of time. They were unitedly contested, and Kumaraswamy wife was the candidate. Now the Kumaraswamy brother-in-law. The symbol has changed. The symbol is, earlier it was Janata Dal, now it is the BJP symbol. Okay. Apart from that, nothing new.
So is this election, the Congress's guarantees which propelled y'all to a win, some say, and also helped y'all in Telangana. Now the Prime Minister, the BJP, says there is a Modi guarantee. Is it going to be the Modi guarantee versus the Congress guarantees at this time?
What is Modi guarantee? I can't understand. Or what is the way which you could see? It is not there. I was speaking to various leaders on these issues. But there is no... What is the guarantee? See, for any guarantee you wanted to give, first everyone look at what a government has helped us. Whether they have helped us to be economically sound, whether our lifestyle has been increased, whether we have got anything personally or for the state, but nothing is there. Even the state has been deprived, and the consciences have been deprived, and even a common man has been deprived. And why should they vote? Whatever they promised, they could not give. Where they are asking, where is the black money? Whenever I went, I am asking, where is the black money? Where is that 15 lakh to every house? Every individual Jandan account was been opened. What about the job? No farmers have been benefited. All things are there. They are asking it. BJP doesn't have any question answer to it. But we, whatever we have spoken, we have delivered. That is our biggest strength, what we could able to show to the people of Karnataka.
So the Prime Minister, while speaking a couple of days ago, said that the Congress wants to give the wealth of the country. He is quoting the former Prime Minister, Mr. Manmohan, saying that he wants to give the Congress wants to take the wealth of the people and give it to one particular community. What do you make of that, sir?
First, let the poor man Manmohan Singh has done his best to help the people of this country. Modi ji, let him tell what he has done to contribute to the welfare of a common man.
They're saying multiple crimes are taking place, communal crimes are taking place under the Congress, and it's because of the appeasement of the Congress towards the community. The BJP is protesting, multiple statements are coming from the leaders.
BJP has lost its base. They doesn't have anything to tell. They are just one incident has happened, some personal incident or whatever maybe has happened. We are there, the law will take its own course.
Coming towards the end, I would like to ask you, as far as the BJP is concerned, most of their candidates ask the vote in the name of Mr. Modi, Prime Minister of the country. As far as the India Alliance is concerned, at this point in time, with nobody announced as the Prime Minister face, do you feel that gives you, that puts you in a little bit of a disadvantage?
See, as far as Congress is concerned, we are on a coalition mode. We are in the coalition, 22, 23 parties are there. We have decided on a collective leadership. Let us win ourselves, then we will decide on the leadership. That was done even at the UPA time, when Sonia Gandhi was being given an opportunity to be the Prime Minister, ultimately. Now, as far as Modi's name is concerned, because they are changing more than hundreds of candidates, and even in Karnataka, about 14 candidates have been changed. In such is the situation, their faces did not work. All MPs, they continued those MPs, including the sitting ministers. They would have lost terribly. That is why they have shifted the candidates and not given to the sitting MPs. That shows that the failure of the Karnataka party.
So in the past, your predictions have come true. This time, would you like to make a prediction here at Times Now to tell us what do you think the Congress's chances here in Karnataka in terms of a number, if you could put a number?
Of course, I will tell. I will ask. I will travel in the North Karnataka. Let this first phase be over. I have to see, assess on my own eyes. I don't believe with anyone, or I don't believe with your survey.
Yeah.
I have to believe with my own eyes. I will go there, I'll look at, and I have my own political strategy for it. Definitely, I'll come out with the numbers.
In South Karnataka, would you like to put a number?
I think we will cross double digit.
Okay. Also, on a lighter note, how difficult has it been? You, of course, being in charge of Bengaluru development, water has been an issue. The summer heat has been an issue. Through all of this, you've been campaigning. You've been meeting some people. The BJP, in fact, raised some issues where you went and made some promises in certain apartments about solving their problems and said, this is the Deputy Chief Minister and the Bangalore Development Minister trying to threaten voters.
I don't want to threaten voters. I'm just communicating my feelings and my hard commitment. One thing I would like to ask, you are telling water, even Prime Minister also said, at least you should appreciate that with more than 70,000 borewell and this 2,200 talaks being the dry talaks declared, though they did not help us, we are trying to help them at least with the tanker waters. We are able to fulfill. I am asking one question. Had you a bath today morning?
Yes.
If water was not there, you couldn't have your bath also, no?
Yeah.
So you had your bath, everyone had their bath. It is just a propaganda, mispropaganda of the BJP government. We are managing. Kaveri water is there. I have kept it. I have reserved it. Everyone is comfortable. All of us are living well. It is a propaganda going on, but the water, which we have said that you should be very cautious on using this drinking water for washing your vehicles, gardening, washing the cattle. All these things, something has to be saved.